Nagbabalik po ating programang Republika. Ako pa rin po si Eric Espina. Kausap natin si Dr. Rene Obra. Siya po isang physician at psychiatrist. So, Doctor, we started with egoistic. Karon, altruistic. These are the people who commit suicide.
Altruistic. These are, under the altruistic theory, these are the people who are strongly attached to a group. Okay. Like the Al-Qaeda suicide bombers,
okay,
cult members, fraternity members, the kamikaze pilot of the Japanese Imperial Army,
okay,
James Jones in Guyana, they all yes. talk cyanide with the belief that they will all reunite in heaven.
Mga religious.
Mga religious. So, their strong attachment to a group, they don't care as when they, even if they will die, as long as it will be for the benefit of the group.
Okay.
That's altruism.
Okay.
The third theory is the anomie. Anomie theory is the reason why people who has attained a certain height in their career as a person,
okay,
they are already very popular, moneyed, influential,
okay,
then for some reasons found themselves back to square one.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Say for example, you are a lawyer, you are a doctor, then you are quote drug trafficking.
Yes.
Or is doing embarrassing antisocial. Antisocial or criminal act.
Yes.
So some of them will call, not all.
Okay.
Okay. So these are the theories. I'll repeat: egoistic,
altruistic,
and anomic theory. There are the reasons why people will commit suicide. We call this copycat.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, copycat suicide is the fans of somebody. A very popular actor, for example, committed suicide in that particular day. Then the myth of suicide is being copied by their followers, by their fans. No? And the same date, we call it anniversary suicide.
Anniversary suicide.
Anniversary suicide.
Okay.
Or copycat. I mean, mentioned this in some other groups, Eric.
There
was one time when the provincial health worker called me, Doctor, will you please help us? Because there are students in the Bantayan town, north of Cebu.
Yes.
Who committed suicide because they were not promoted to the next higher grade level.
Okay.
For reasons that, I don't know, according to the teacher, not able to comply with the requirements.
Yes.
You know what happened, Eric?
What happened?
Nine others hung themselves.
Nine
others. But of course, they were already forewarned, were aware already about the possibility that the others will also do the same.
Yes.
It was aborted.
Uh-huh.
But the two really died.
Uh-huh.
So this is how, you know, strong is their emotional feeling towards the other members of the group.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And then other people will commit suicide because they are on top of their anger. Because this is sometimes crime of passion.
Crime of passion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you are on top of your anger, and you are very angry that you are already out of control.
Self-destruction.
Then it happened that you can no longer control your emotion.
Yes.
You wanted to kill that person, but it just happened that that person happens to be very important to you.
To you. So you'd rather destroy yourself?
Rather destroy yourself.
Uh-huh.
So that's why the definition of suicide is an introverted murder.
Introverted murder. Okay.
That is against the Ten Commandments.
Yes,
thou shalt not kill.
Yes.
Number 5, I think.
Yes,
right?
yes.
So, thou shalt not kill. That's one of the Ten Commandments. So, instead that You direct your anger to somebody, you redirect your anger
upon yourself
for reasons like you cannot do that to the other person because he happens to be a very important person to you.
How serious is depression as a problem among
depression
Filipinos?
Depression is number one because I repeat, all of us will
undergo
depressed.
At one point in our lives, we will experience depression.
We will experience depression. Nobody can brag or claim that there's no way or reason for that for you to become depressed. But when can this become a disorder? Just like anxiety. When can this become a disorder?
Mm-hmm.
When your anxiety or depression
mm-hmm.
will affect your level of functioning socially, mm-hmm. occupationally and personally,
uh-huh.
that you are no longer in your normal self.
Uh-huh.
Say, for example, you are employed in a company, you commit gross mistakes,
mm-hmm.
you are no longer very vocal as before the onset of the depression,
mm-hmm.
you are no longer particular about your personal hygiene.
Yes.
You no longer talk, then you have a poor concentration and memory.
Okay.
So,
di ka katulog.
You have either insomnia, dili katulog, or
too much sleeping.
You are either anorexic or no appetite, or
eating too much.
Voracious appetite.
Appetite, okay.
So any extreme,
okay,
that might happen to you, which is unusual. Your co-employees can observe you.
Okay.
And then you have this loss of focus. I repeat. That of course will tantamount to gross mistakes in your assigned works. So, and some of them will contemplate or saying suicidal ideation.
This leads me to my question, Doctor, no? We'll go into the psyche of the millennials, and then, of course, drugs. Kay taas mga kayong drugs, no?
Yes.
So in the psychology of the millennials, they are, they want a right now mentality. Karunda yun ba? And then quick gratification. And then, I don't know whether the concentration level is also very moving, no? But ang mga millennials, is there a tendency for them to, is it easier for them to commit suicide?
Yeah, millennials are people who were born from 1982 to 2004.
Okay.
I belong to the baby boomer, Eric.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Baby boomer are those who were born in the late or 1940s to mga 1960s, no?
Oh, these are the war years.
No. the physically fit, the very active, you know. Baby boomers, I belong to that group. But the millennials, 1982 to 2004.
Yes.
So these are the generation Y.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
So
how are they?
Yeah, they are quite very so we call this one adventurous.
Okay.
These are the kind of people who will try to discover something.
Adventurous,
new.
Adventurous.
Adventurous, huh?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
High risk.
High risk because anything that is not your usual way of doing things will tantamount to risky consequences.
And they're
or
not
painful consequences.
They're not really romantic. Are they romantic?
They are quite.
Quite the opposite.
Quite the opposite.
Diretso na yun.
Diretso na yun.
Oh, oh.
So, these are the people. Who were born after the IDSA revolution?
Okay.
IDSA revolution was 1986, right?
Yes, yes.
So we have so many millennials
who commit suicide.
Commit suicide for some reasons.
And they put it on social media.
Social media. They even video
tape themselves.
Tape themselves and let other people see what they are doing.
Has social media become their How is it? Their friend? They would rather deal with virtual reality rather than human beings.
Yes. That's why not long ago, I was asked to talk about cyberbullying.
Yes.
In University of Cebu Doctors University.
Yes, yes.
Then, because of the social media, cyberbullying is happening left and right every day.
Mm-hmm.
And the millennials are quite the group which are highly involved in this kind of activities.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
So what is cyberbullying? Because as the name implies, it involves internet.
Yes,
and,
yes, yes.
And we have so many cases of cyberbullying which don't amount to depression.
And then they cannot handle it?
They cannot handle it.
Uh-huh.
Then they will quit
uh-huh.
as a student or as a worker.
Okay.
So I said the best way, by the way, to handle cyberbullying, do not confront the bully.
Okay.
Do not confront the bully. I repeat.
Uh-huh.
What you will do is to strike out, delete the number of the bully, or you change your number.
Uh-huh.
So there's no way for him to.
Or you make your account private.
Yes. Yeah. So do not confront because the more that he will, what we call in Cebuano mugara.
Now, bipolar.
Yeah.
Is there more bipolar individuals now?
There are. I don't have the statistics, but we are starting to have a national
census?
Recording.
Okay.
Okay.
What is a bipolar person?
A bipolar is a person who has a mood swing.
Extreme mood swings.
Extreme mood swing. So it could be, as the name implies, bi, meaning it could either be
sobra kalipay,
manic.
Okay, and then or depressive.
And then depressed.
Okay.
Manic and depressed. But we have so many subtypes, bipolar. Depressed, bipolar, manic, bipolar max. Now, but in general, para dili ta maglibog, bipolar means mood swing.
This is a disorder, doctor, huh?
This is a disorder because your functional level, socially, occupationally, and personally is affected.
Okay.
So, I repeat, basically, bipolar means you are either manic you feel as if you are full of energy, you are on top of everybody, you are in command of everything, you are grandiose, you are in control.
Okay.
Then all of a sudden, for no apparent reason at all, will develop depression, which is the opposite. You will no longer talk, you will no longer socialize.
And are there more people taking now medication for this?
You have medications for
what this. What is this? This actually balances out the chemicals in your body.
Basically, if our neurotransmitters in our brain will increase, and that's serotonin, mm-hmm. you are somewhat hyper,
okay.
and it goes down, you are depressed.
Okay.
So for people who are non-medical, can understand me very as simple as possible. Just imagine blood sugar.
Okay.
Blood sugar, I asked a diabetologist what is the normal, 100 to 120, uh-huh. depending on the fasting or random blood sugar. But if your blood sugar will shoot up, you are diabetic.
Yes.
Which for me equivalent to maybe manic.
Okay.
But if your blood sugar will shoot down, you are hypoglycemic, which is equivalent for me as depressed.
Somebody told me before that I will not mention who he said, kaning tawhanan siya ba, bipolar na siya. Muna usahay pa imo na siya kape kay para makuan mawal. Tinuod ba na?
Yeah, coffee has caffeine.
Okay.
And caffeine is like shabu, it's a stimulant.
So makatabang gyud ay?
Makatabang if he is depressed.
Okay. Okay now. Oh, okay.
But I'm not saying you take shabu because you are depressed.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay. We're going to pause for the final break, and then we'll get back to Dr. Rene Obra, yeah. when Republic returns.